Today I explain why Alabama's second red zone drive in the third quarter failed in the red zone. So I'll just go ahead and tell you now. First of all, Tua just missed on the first play. There was a pass interference that was missed on the next play. And it was a great defense and a missed opportunity on the last play. So I'm going to break them down in that order, starting with the second and fourth play on the 14-yard mark. I'm going to the red zone here for Alabama. Tua Tagovailoa in shotgun. Josh Jacobs is set right. Three wide receivers to the left. Tight end number 84 is in line on the left side is Hill Hinches. He's running on an out route. Henry Ruggs is the closest wide receiver. He runs a slant. Jalen Waddle is the middle wide receiver of the three. He runs a post. So if you notice, all these routes are running to the left, including Devontae Smith, who's on the far right side, runs an in route. This play will eat man coverage alive. The line held up just enough, even though the pocket was collapsing a bit. Tua Tagovailoa had every last option open at one point on this play. Henry Ruggs was the easiest to see, and Tua fired it. This miss is simply on Tua. The ball is just a bit too high. That is literally the only reason this was not completed. Unfortunate play for Alabama, because as you will see, the following plays ended in tragedy. Third and four, next play here, 5 minutes, 54 seconds. Tua Tagovailoa is in the shotgun. The running back is set left. Jerry Jeudy is the only wide receiver on the left side. Two wide receivers on the right side. Irv Smith is inline tight end on the left side. Clemson is playing man coverage again. Two outside wide receivers are they're played tight, while the slot wide receiver is played off man coverage. Jerry Jeudy is motioned in to identify and confirm the coverage. This pass protection is good, although look at Cleveland Farrell who work Jonah Williams over there on that top side. Based on the pre-snap read, this is man coverage and Jerry Jeudy is running an out route. This should be an easy conversion. Tua fires the ball out there in the right place with good placement, but it's incomplete. Why? Because the cornerback, AJ Terrell, held Jerry Jeudy on the route. As Jerry Jeudy put the move on him to get outside, Terrell grabs Judy's Jeudy's inside of his shoulders pad in the neck area with his right hand. He also gives a tug to the back of Jerry Jeudy's jersey, effectively slowing him down enough so that he can't get to the ball. So there's two instances of pass interference on the same play. Nick Saban saw it and he couldn't even believe it. He just looked there like, you know what, I'm just not gonna even say anything right now. But weirdly enough, you know, he didn't blow up about it, but it was just weird that this pass interference was completely missed. But also, as I always say, I'm consistent on this. There's always missed calls back and forth either way, but in this particular case, this was a missed call. Fourth down, so we're going to the next play. This is fourth and four, 5 minutes and 50 seconds. So Tua Tagovailoa is in the shotgun. It's the same formation as the last play, but Jerry Jeudy is already close on the left side. Clemson is playing zone this time, and this is confirmed by Devontae Smith's motion from the far wide receiver position. Mark Fields, the cornerback, tightens his coverage, but he still remains wide. The goal is to have the defense watch the eyes of the quarterback. Typically, the quarterback runs don't work against zone. It's the reason why I'm telling you that. Clemson has three down linemen, but they send two blitzers, one linebacker and the boundary cornerback, AJ Terrell. Alabama has six blockers, but five Clemson guys won against Alabama's six blockers. The main reason why is that Christian Wilkins split the double team of Ross Pierce-Baker and Alex Leatherwood. That ruined this play. Josh Jacobs chipped AJ Terrell enough, and Jonah Williams forced Cleveland Farrell wide, so Tua Tagovailoa would have room to step up. But because Christian Wilkins is free, Tua Tagovailoa has to run up the pocket, even though Jerry Jeudy is coming open in a space in his own to his right. Tua Tagovailoa commits to running and is trying to get the first down on his run. And like I said, that's not going to work against the zone typically, even though he almost gets it on this play. So I'm sure Tua Tagovailoa saw Jerry Jeudy, but and he could have reset and maybe hit Jerry Jeudy for that first down. But like I said, he was already committed to running, but that is something that maybe he could have done. It would have been wide open and an easy conversion. So this was a missed opportunity, although understandable why it was missed, and a great defensive play by Clemson at the same time. So Clemson being in the zone at this time and sending that blitz, they really created this situation and put Tua in a hard circumstance there. So that's why Alabama failed on the second red zone drive at the third quarter here, and once again came away with no points. So I'll be back with another video. Let me know what you all think about this particular drive. What do you think about these plays here? All right, see you next time.